Hello all you huggable lollipops, I am Joseph the Huggist, and this is Secondhand Gaming, and this is Thrift Store Finds. If you can see it in back, I've had a pretty nice find today, well, this month. So, I have all PS2 related items. So, actually, three of these is a rerun because I found them before. There are five games, two, and a PlayStation 2 console. In its original box. The box is beat up, but I don't care. I wanted it all the same. It's not often I come across it. So, the first PS2 game, movie licensed game, Chicken Little. If you've seen any of these episodes before, you'll know that I love movie licensed games only because I love movies. Free Inside, one adult matinee or child movie pass to see Chicken Little. So, it was actually a better platformer than I thought it would be. And this is the follow-up to my favorite game of all time, Metal Gear Solid 2, Sons of Liberty. And this is not my favorite Metal Gear game. It's actually, to be honest, it's my least favorite Metal Gear game. I've played Metal Gear 1 multiple times, Metal Gear 3 multiple times, Metal Gear 4 multiple times. I think I've only played Metal Gear 2 twice. Solid Snake is back in the latest installment of the critically acclaimed series from director. Sorry, Kojima, I cannot say your name right. I'm not going to butcher it. Top secret weapons technology is being mysteriously transported under cover of an oil tanker to an unknown destination. Armed with an arsenal of new weapons, supplies, and stealth maneuvers, it's up to Snake to infiltrate the transport and keep the deadly weapons of mass destruction from falling into the wrong hands. I like how they blatantly... Solid Snake is... He is back, but he's not the main character. So... when I first played, like when I was younger, I didn't have a job where I didn't spend a lot of my money on story narrative games. I spent most of my money on sports-based games. Spent a lot more of my time playing sports-based games and wrestling games. Too sweet. But... So when Metal Gear Solid came out, I played the first one a ton, and then sort of went from playing NBA Live, Madden, wrestling games, all these other sport games, so I never really played narrative games. So when I started getting back into narrative gaming, Metal Gear 3 is the game that sort of brought me back, and then I went back and played Metal Gear 4 next, and then I played Metal Gear 2, so I played it last, which was a mistake. But now that I have it again, I gave a PlayStation 2 and every copy of Metal Gear that I had to someone because they've never played it and I really wanted them to play it. And I was just going to end up rebuying the games anyways like I just did. So, it's a great series. All right. Part of another great series that I got to either these next three games are reruns and I either plan on giving these away when people ask for a PlayStation 2 game or I'm planning on selling them. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with, but I know I'm going to have them and maybe I'll take them into Half Price Books one day and trade a whole bunch of them to get one really good game. I don't know. But Grand Theft Auto Vice City came with everything there. And this is the third time I found this game now. Jackson Dexter again. So the gameplay footage for this one is going to be a rerun. And in there is Jack's 2 instruction manual. I wish they had Jax 2 there because I don't have that. And then Jax 3, no instruction manual. So, three reruns, but I'm alright with that. I'm probably going to just sell them or give them to some people who are struggling with their collection And then, now, to the PlayStation 2, with, as you can see, the box is beat up right here, right here, right here. There's some tape here, and the, it's got a little missing there, but, I mean, the back of the box is pretty decent shape. And when this game came out, when this system came out, Gran Turismo 3 was in the back of the box, Twisted Metal Black, Kinetic, 989 Sports, NFL Game Day 2002, Draken, The Ancient Gates, Eco, Dark Cloud, Metal Gear Solid 2, Sons of Liberty, and Soul Reaver. So, I was ecstatic to find this. I think I still have all my other PlayStation boxes. They're probably beat up because I didn't keep them in the safe spot when I was storaging them in my youth. I keep them in a better spot now. But having the box is significantly better than not having the box. Alright, with all that being said, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.
Great, an acorn. Acorns again. The movie, now the merchandising? What'll they come up with next? Chew toys? Yes! There's gotta be another way in. I just gotta find some change.
Programming with a message from the State Department. All bridges and some roads in the Vice City metropolitan area have been closed because of a severe weather warning. Meteorologists are tracking Hurricane Hermione, which has devastated five Caribbean islands and is heading for Vice City. More updates soon.
You morons don't have
to wait any right now. I want 10 minutes alone with this asshole.
Tommy Vercetti is an innocent man.
Fight me then. Fight!
I'll call for backup!
Don't make me kill you!
Your ID! Don't run away from me!
Are you enjoying this?
Mary.
This ain't
crazy. I've been here all the way down here.
I give up.
One, two, three,
That's Fahrenheit, not Celsius. But
it is boiling in here. I'm taking it off to this next record. It is hot, baby.
Give me a gun! Beware of your woman, local. Treachery is deep. By the coming of the spring, she shall be no more.
War changed my life!
Author of two best-selling self-help books translated from the original runic into 25 languages, Thor has helped millions realize their dreams.
Beware the trap set by the frost giants. Carry your magic hammer.
Available on record or cassette, the personal Norse Power Program looks to the myths of the Vikings for answers.
Can you give my husband and I some advice to help keep things hot in the bedroom?
Take a longbow, 20 of your finest men. Head to where the sun sets. There you go. Pillage, plunder, and burn all that you find.
And if you order now, you'll receive Thor's subliminal tape series, saying the wisdom of the gods while sleeping.
Accept the crystal cup. At the feast, beware the dwarf.
Thor's personal Norse power program. Call now, 866-PILLAGE. That's 866-PILLAGE.
Hi, I'm BJ Smith, football player, fitness...
candidates have won the challenge.
That's right. We bid. You haven't forgotten what I taught you, Jack.
Anyone can make a few measly jumps. Now let's see how you rate against the living. Readjust the matter formers. Prepare the arena for full combat.
Prepare the arena for full combat.
I just said that.
I know, I was just adding, you know, how you do the thing with the... Anyway, prepare the warriors.
You mean we have to fight against actual people? With actual weapons? Who actually will hurt us?
Fine, bring them on.
All right, that's it. I want to be on his shoulder.
Have asked the rocks, but the rocks do not recall. Even the rocks do not recall. Every bone in my body tells me that the answers rest on the shoulders of a young boy. Oblivious to his destiny, uninterested in the search for truth, and rejecting of my guidance. And why would he want to listen to old Samus the Sage anyway? I'm only the master of green ego, one of the wisest men on the planet. So it seems the answer begins not with careful research or sensible thinking. Nay, as with many of fate's mysteries, it begins with but a small act of disobedience.
Hey, Jack. Old Green Stuff told us not to come here.
Continue your search for artifacts, Aniko. If the locals possess precursor items, know what to do.
Deal harshly with anybody who strays from the village. We will attack it in due time.
What are we doing here anyway, Jack? This place gives me the creeps. Huh? Oh, stupid precursor junk. Eek! What is that dark ooze? It sure don't look friendly. The sage yaps on about the precursors that built this place all the time. Where did they go? Why did they build this crud? Now, I like precursor orbs and power cells as much as the next guy. But if you ask me, they must have been real losers. Wow! How did you do that? I think we're in trouble! Stung. I told you we shouldn't have come here, and you listened! What? Okay. I'm fine.
Green tarnation do you two want?
I was...
Don't tell me. Instead of heeding my wisdom, the two of you went mucking around in the only place that I told you not to go. Misty Island.
That's right. And then...
And, Daxter, you finally took a much-needed bath, but in a bathtub filled with dark eco.
Look, old man, are you gonna keep yapping, or are you gonna help me out of this mess?
I'm gonna keep yapping, because in my professional opinion, the change is an improvement. And besides, I couldn't help you if I wanted to.
What?
There's only one person who has studied dark eco long enough to have a chance at returning you to your previous form. Carl Acheron, the sage. But he lives far to the north. Far, far to the north. Nobody has spoken to him in ages. I would teleport you there, but I can't do that either. None of the three sages that maintain the other teleporter gates have seen fit to turn their ends on for quite a while. The only other way north is by foot through the Fire Canyon, but its volcanic soil is hot enough to melt precursor metal. You can't just walk through it.
But you could fly over it if you had a zoomer equipped with a heat shield. I just happen to be working on such a thing at this very moment. All I would need is 20 power cells to give it enough energy to withstand the canyon's heat. Isn't that right, Daddy?
Yes, Kira, that might work. But where are a boy and a half going to get 20 power cells?
From the villagers. Most of them have a power cell or two stashed away somewhere. And even if they aren't willing to just give them away, greasing their palms with a few precursor orbs should do the trick. And I bet there are even more of them out in the wilds just waiting for some brave adventurer to find.
Well, we've got the brave adventurer at least.
Brave adventurer? You two couldn't find your way out of the village without training. Before you do anything else, you better go through the warp gate and get some practice on Geyser Rock.
We won't find any more of that dark, gooey eco stuff, will we? Cause I'd hate to fall in again and turn into you.
Get in there before I turn you both into ferns.
This device is a communicator. With it, my father and I can give you advice at any time during your quest. Floating egg-shaped things are precursor orbs. Collect enough of them, and some of the villagers will give you a power cell in exchange. This is a power cell, the most important precursor artifact you can find. You need to collect 20 of these so I can power the heat shield for your A-Grab Zoomer.
Sometimes you'll want to hit things with a greater force. To break one of these boxes, you should jump in the air and then dive down onto it, hands first.
Hey, you found one of my scout flies. I sent 7 of them to each area to look for power cells, but the lurkers must have captured them all. Than the floating clusters. This vent will give you a full charge of blue eco, letting you use it for the maximum time.
Snake, go through that door into the ship's interior. Push the action button down and...
Somebody there. Who is that?
It's the enemy. I need help.
Understood. Yeah.